Hey there, YTPC. Michelle Baruch coming at you from a cute little parklet pretty much right in front of my apartment. Happy Cobb Tuesday to you. Hope things are well wherever you are. It is an absolutely magnificent day out here. Now, you're going to notice right away, a little shiny up top. I bought myself a little toy, a little head shaver. It's pretty nice, though I have to say, you know, it's, what, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. I've got some good 5 o'clock stubble going. But I highly suggest it. It's very, very zen, very therapeutic activity to run an electric razor made for head shaving all over your head. So what am I smoking in my fine no-name cob here? I am smoking something very, very special and very unique to me, sent to me from my friend Hector. Little Gawith and Hogarth Enerdale. Wow. I will spare you the cancer picture on the bottom of this European tin. I'm going to set this down for a second because I never have mastered the art of talking and pipe smoking. But, such good stuff, guys. So this is very interesting. It came in plastic inside. Great vacuum seal, still intact. Not sure if this is the date code or not. Can't tell with the sun going here. You can even see that. There you go. Looks to me like it's December 2nd, 2017. Not sure if that is true or not. If so, this is a couple and a half years old. What I'm hoping you can see, and if you can't, go to my Instagram page because I took some close-up photos that are just magnificent. Can you see the sparklingness going on there in the sun? This is just covered with plume. It is like a frozen wonderland of shiny sugar crystals going on there. And it smells like nothing else. Hector did tell me that this does smell, or he didn't say smell. He said that this is granny pants. I assumed at the time he was as much talking about the flavor and flavoring as the smell. It is a really unique tobacco. It has Brazilian Virginias, Malawi, and a third one I'm forgetting. Not your classic Virginias. And they make up about 86% of the blend, I believe. And there's even some Malawi Burley. Exotic stuff, my friends. Also, it's flavored with a kitchen sink of flavorings. Supposedly some almond and some rum. I think I taste a little of the almond. I'm not sure I taste the rum. But there is this pervasive, well, that's a loaded word. There is this dominant flavor that reminds me of old lady perfume, like drinking what I imagine drinking old lady's perfume out of the bottle must be like. There is a million things going on here. I should also, since I'm looking at it, show you the beautiful ash that it's giving me. This is right out of the tin, guys, too. This is marvelous. I think I taste like several different fruits in here. It's also very floral, especially in the retrohale. Yeah, This will ghost the living bejillus out of any pipe that you put it in. I even read somewhere that somebody said it ghosted their meerschaum. So, perfect thing for Cobb Tuesday. Smokes like a champ. Right out of the tin. Wow. You know, it's funny. I didn't read anything about anybody saying that it has any spice to it. But it actually has a pretty distinct, like, white pepper to it that kind of reminds me of cigar leaf, but... With all of the floral and flavor things that are going on here, that spice... Ooh, the sun just went behind a cloud and got cool on my head for a second there. This is really good. I doubt this is something that I would want to smoke all day, and it's certainly not something I would want to smoke every day. But this is something that I think I would find myself, like, craving from time to time. It's just so different. Okay. So, on my normal scale of meh to go get you some, I give this a solid go get you some. Get a tin. Let it sit, let it develop a nice plume. Like I say, the vacuum pack on this was a nice loud hiss when I opened it. Really well stored. Yeah, good stuff, guys. Anyway, hope you're doing well wherever you are. Have a fantastic Cobb Tuesday. And wonderful rest of the week. And I hope you guys are very well. Sei gesund.